Scripture lesson is coming to us from St. Matthew chapter 10, reading from verse 1 to St. John chapter 10, reading from verse 1 to 10. Sister Cox will read.
Good morning, brethren. St. John chapter 10, reading from verse 1 to 10. We'll read alternate verses. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that entereth not by the door into the sheepfold, but climbeth up some other way, the same is a thief and a robber. To him the porter openeth, and the sheep hear his voice, and he calleth his own sheep by name, and leadeth them out. And a stranger will they not follow, but will flee from him, for they know not the voice of strangers. Then said Jesus unto them again, verily, verily, I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved, and shall go in and out, and find pasture. Ten and last. If cometh not, but for to steal, and to kill, and to destroy, I am come that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly. This is the word of the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Could you please remain standing? I'm calling on Deacon Hyde, who will pray the opening prayer. Deacon.
O God, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Your will on earth, O God Almighty, be done as it is in heaven. Father, we just want to thank you for another day. Another day that you have made, O God. And we will rejoice and be glad in it. We thank you, O God, that we can come into your presence to give glory, to give honor to thee. You alone are worthy. This morning, O God, as we stand before you, nothing in our hands we bring, O God, but simply to the cross we cling. Because we know, dear God, it's only you why we are here this morning. And we just want to thank you, O God Almighty, that we are on top of our grave. We, O God Almighty, are not numbered with the dead, but we are here in living, standing, O God Almighty, giving praise and glory. We can raise our hands, we can shout, we can cry, we can, O God Almighty, move around, and there is so much to thank you for, so much to praise you for, so much to exalt your holy name for. You have been such a wonderful God, excellent and awesome, almighty, all-powerful, King of kings and Lord of lords, and we lord you, we worship you, we exalt you, we give you praise, glory, and honor. This morning, O God, I pray that you will hover over this building. You will make your blood, dear God, that shed from Calvary, touch each and every soul that come through these doors. We pray, dear God, that none will go back through the door the way we came, dear God, but you will touch, you will wash, you will cleanse, you will purge, you will empty, you will dismantle, you will move the things, dear God, that are not of us. And everything, dear God, that is not of you, you will blot it out in the name of Jesus. You will back back forces, you will cut down stronghold, you will tear down and you will pull down and you will set up, oh God Almighty, a oh God, a platform of worship, dear God, for you. I pray that your people will come in one accord, one aim, one mind, looking forward, dear God Almighty, just to hear from you. Have your way today, dear God. Touch your man servant, oh God, as the word go forth. Touch, dear God, the musician. Bless them indeed, the praise team. Unctionize them in the name of Jesus. The moderator, move your Holy Spirit over him, dear God Almighty. I pray, dear God, that you will just go through and just touch from soul to soul. Move from bench to bench. And anything that is not of you, any sickness, anything, dear God, I come against it in the name of Jesus. I pray, dear God, that only deliverance, oh God Almighty, and your Holy Spirit will flow through this building today. Let your precious blood, that one that flows from Calvary, when it reaches its hurt, it trembles like a drunken man. Shake up 4 Davis Street today. Shake up 4 Davis Street. Shake up 4 Davis Street with your anointing. Shake up St. Anne's Bay. Mash up some something in the name of Jesus. Take charge, oh God Almighty. Do for us what not a powers can do. And let your anointing, your powerful anointing, be felt among us like an earthquake, dear God. As we shake from the hill of 4 Davis Street, it will jerk down by the police station. And oh God Almighty, it will mesmerize the sea. And oh God, and your Holy Spirit will overtake St. Anne and steer down, dear God Almighty, which I heard on the news last night, will come to know you as Lord and Savior. Some of those young men, dear God, who are giving problem over there will cry out, I heal, I heal, I cannot bear it no longer. And they will run and come to know you, Lord God Almighty. Oh God, can give them peace in their soul. Thank you for what you have done. Thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your grace. Thank you that your ears are not heavy and your hands are not short. And there is nothing, dear God, that is too hard for you. None of these young men, dear God, were born to do what they're doing, but they were mesmerized by the enemy. And I pray, dear God, that you will just step in and deliver them, set them free, give them a breakthrough in the name of Jesus, and touch them again. I stretch my hand, dear God Almighty, across this parish, dear God, and I pray for sanctification. I pray for cleansing. I pray for purging in the name of Jesus. Have your way over every service, though, God Almighty, in Jamaica today. Every church door that opened, visit, pay a visit, take charge, God Almighty. God Almighty, this virus that is going around, I pray, dear God Almighty, that you will stamp your feet upon it now in the name of Jesus. Oh God, it's full time now, dear God Almighty. You said you will not give your people no more than they can bear, and I think it's too much now, too long, dear God Almighty. Your people, some people are suffering and some are dying all across the world. I know, dear God Almighty, you do nothing out of your will, but I pray that you'll have mercy. Just have mercy in the name of Jesus. Take over the rest of the service now and have thine own way. Have thine own way, God. Lead, direct, cut, clear, cramp, and paralyze as we give everything into your wonderful care. We thank you now for what you have done, what you're doing, and what you're about to do. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we tell you thanks in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. Good morning, church. Happy Father's Day to all the fathers. Praise God. At this time, the praise team.
Hallelujah. Can the people of God jump to your feet, lift up holy hands, and give a shout of hallelujah? Hallelujah. If you are glad to be numbered among the living this morning, why not lift up your hands, throw your heads back, and shout out hallelujah? The scriptures say, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. So if you are a living being this morning, lift up your hands and just praise the Lord right now. Praise him for what you've been through. Praise him for what he's taking you through. Praise him for what is yet to come. But just worship him right now. Hallelujah. 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 It is a blessing to be in the house of God this morning. So we're going to sing, and we're going to worship, and we're going to praise God. So whatever hindrance you may have come here with this morning, you need to lay it aside right now. Just push it out the window or wherever, because you are in Liberty Hall. And in Liberty Hall, you have freedom to worship, freedom to exalt the name of God, freedom to do whatever you want in the presence of God once it's magnifying God. Hallelujah. Oh, bless God. Hallelujah. 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 Look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. He healed my body, he touched my mind. He saved me just in time. I'm gonna praise his name. His name is just the same. I'm gonna praise him. Look what the Lord has done. And everybody say, look what the Lord has done.
Look what the Lord has done.
He healed my body,
he touched my mind,
he saved me, just in time, I'm gonna praise his name,
his name is just the same,
I wanna praise,
I'm gonna praise
look what the Lord,
look what the Lord has done,
one more time, look what the Lord has done,
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 he healed my body, say,
my body,
he touched
my mind,
he saved me,
he saved
right
me.
In time,
just I'm gonna praise his name,
his name is just the same,
he said he's just the same,
I'm gonna praise his name,
I'm gonna praise him,
look what the Lord
has done,
I've got it, say I've got it,
oh,
said, I went to the enemy's camp.
See, I went to the enemy's camp, and I took back what he stole from me.
Took it back.
Took back what he stole from me.
Oh, I took it back.
Took back what he stole from me.
I went
to the enemy's camp,
and I
took back what he stole from me.
He's under my feet,
under my feet.
Satan
is under my
feet. I went to the enemy.
I went to the enemy's camp,
and I
looked back what he stole from me.
I took it back.
Looked back what he stole from me.
Oh, I took it back.
Looked back what he stole from me. I went to the enemy's camp,
and I
looked back what he stole from me. He's under my feet. Under my feet, Satan is under my feet.
I'm coming
from the enemy's camp, and I took back my joy in thee.
Took back my joy.
Took back my joy in thee.
Took back my joy.
Took back my joy.
I'm coming from
the enemy's camp,
and I took back it.
Took back my joy in thee. He's under my feet. Under my feet. Satan is under my
feet. I went to the enemy's camp.
And I took back what he stole from me.
Took back your joy.
Took back what he stole from me.
Took back your peace.
Took back what he stole from me.
I went
to the enemy's camp.
And I
took back what he stole from me. He's under my feet. Under my feet. Satan is under my feet.
One more time, sing.
I went to the enemy's camp.
And I
took back what he stole from me.
I took it back.
Took back what he stole from me.
Oh, I took it back.
Took back what he stole from me.
I went to the enemy's camp.
He's under my feet.
Brother Chris, keep playing. Forgive me. But it says he's under my feet. People of God, you know what? Trump upon the enemy. He's not said for your joy and your peace, and the Lord your God has commanded you to take back what the enemy has stolen from you. And you are under my feet. Come on, people of God. You must trample the enemy just by your actions. You make him know so you're serious. Let's go.
He's under my feet.
Just lift up holy hands and worship God right now. If you believe that you have the victory over the enemy this morning, just take a moment and worship God. Hallelujah. Oh God, hallelujah. We lift our voices. We use the very breath that has been loaned to us to give you the praise, to give you the glory, to give you the honor that is due to you, mighty God. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Oh, glory to God. Oh, glory to the Son of God. Oh, Jesus, we bless you. Oh, we Shabbat and Barak you with our praise. We are standing in his presence this morning, not because of anything that we have done, but because he's a merciful God. He's a glorious God. He's a faithful Father, and his promises are yes and amen. Oh, glory to God. We bless your name, God. Oh, Jesus. This is the air I breathe.
Hallelujah.
Oh God, oh God. This is the air I breathe.
your holy presence is living in me. Help me say, this is my daily bread.
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 Somebody sing your very word.
Your very word
is spoken to me.
Spoken to me.
And I say, for God this morning, say, and I am lost without you.
I am so lost.
Oh God, come and find me. And I say, and I am desperate for you.
For you.
My soul is desperate for you.
Higher,
let our King.
say, this morning God is saying amen. You've prayed day and night, night and day. This is his response. Amen. Oh God, oh God. Amen. Yeah. Hallelujah, bless you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Don't stop worshiping because we stop singing.
Hallelujah.
Don't stop your worship because the song has stopped. Your worship, your praise is not hinged on any song this morning, but your experience and your relationship with the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Continue to bask in His presence. Bask in His presence. Bask in His presence. Oh God, oh God. Oh Jesus, hallelujah. Oh God, hallelujah. We worship You from our souls, from our hearts this morning, God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm desperate for You. To be desperate means you have no other choice. Is God your only choice you have left this morning? Or are you waiting until the other options run out? To be desperate means to have no other option. And as I'm desperate for You, I am desperate for God this morning. Oh Jesus, hallelujah. Oh God, oh God. Oh God. We worship You. We praise Your name. We bless You, God, forever and the same. From the rising of the sun to the setting of the very same, You are worthy. Oh, I'm desperate. I'm lost without You. I'm desperate for You. I'm lost without You, and I'm desperate, say,
I'm desperate for You,
oh Lord,
oh Lord,
I continue in worship, the scripture, sorry, the hymn for this morning is hymn 120. I heard an old story, how our Savior came from glory, how he gave his life on Calvary to save a wretch like me. Hallelujah. Brother Kiss, that same key.
Hallelujah.
120, hallelujah. I heard an old story, how a Savior came from glory, how he gave his life on Calvary to save a wretch like me. I heard about his groaning, of his precious blood atoning. Then I repented of my sins
and of the
people. Oh, victory,
victory. My Savior forever. He sought me and he bought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me and I know him, and all my love is to him. He plunged me into victory beneath the cleansing blood.
Verse 2, I heard about his healing of his cleansing blood.
Sing up.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. 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 Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. 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 I must take time to welcome each and every one of you that are here. Our host pastor, Sister Foster, Reverend and Sister Somerville, all the officers, musicians, the ushers, and all of you wonderful brethren who have come week after week. God eternally bless you as we worship the Lord today in the beauty of holiness. I'm calling upon the ushers of this time as we are going to worship with our tithes and offering. Today's tithes and offering.
Hallelujah. Please stand. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We worship you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father in heaven, we worship you, Lord. We exalt your name and I. Lord, we give you thanks this morning for life. Thank you, God, for providing for us. Thank you, God, for your keeping care and your tender mercy towards us. Lord God, we just love you this morning. We just worship you this morning, Lord. You have been good to us, Lord Jesus. And we want to tell you thanks. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Lord, for the tithes and offering, Lord God, that you have provided for your children. Lord God, we ask God that you will bless them in abundance continually as we give you glory and honor and praise. And we tell you thanks in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
God. Sing as I travel through this pilgrim's land, there is a friend with me. Keep me safely through the sinking sand. It is the cry.
When I kneel in prayer, sing and I shout. My Savior came down. From my Lord above, Jesus walks beside me every blessed day, and I know He guides me all the way.
Yes, I am set.
Yes, I'm overshadowed.
Worship the Lord. Let us worship the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. It's a wonderful feeling to be in the house of the Lord. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I must take time out to say thanks for everyone who have participated in today's worship service. Thanks for coming out. And God eternally bless you all as we continue to live for the Lord. Hallelujah. Brother Deacon Jarrett would like to see all the men after church. At this time, I'm handing over the rest of the service to Reverend Foster. God eternally bless you, Reverend Foster.
My brothers and sisters, good morning. Amen. To God be the glory. Great things he has done. Giving thanks to Almighty God for his greatness, for his majesty, and for his wonderful and marvelous grace. Glory to God. I just want to lift your hands where you are and give him a praise in the house. Give him another praise in the house. Praise God. Let me join in saying welcome to you all. Glad to have you. And those of you who are visiting with us, we want to let you know we are happy to have you. And may the Lord God of heaven bless you all. There's two persons. Is Marissa and Juliet here? Marissa and Juliet? No. Glory to God. Glory to God. Let me take the opportunity of saying to all the fathers in the house and those who are listening to me this morning, Happy Father's Day. Praise God. God bless you for playing your role as a good father over the years. And may you continue to fulfill your responsibility, not only to your children, but to all those children who you come in contact with. God richly bless you. Again, Happy Father's Day. Glory to God. Remember that Sunday will be the closing of our in-gathering. So, if you don't touch your leader yet, you can touch them. Come Sunday. Amen. Amen. You're vexed with me now. Me still I got to talk, you know. God bless you. Before Sister Pattinger come to sing one of my favorite songs, I want you to turn your Bibles with me to the other text that I'm going to use along with St. John 10. Colossians 2 and 2 verses there, 9 and 10. For in him dwelleth all the fullness of the Godhead bodily, and ye are complete in him, which is the head of all principality and power. Glory to God. My brothers and sisters, the word that God laid on my heart, not a Father's Day message today, although I would love every father to walk in the Holy Ghost, the power of the Holy Spirit. Believers living the Spirit-filled life. Sister Pattinger.
Let us bless the Lord. Praise God. Like a lamb to the slaughter like a sheep before his shearer, like a beggar to the grave, like a king, just a slave, born in poverty, died in cruelty, suffer agony, just for you and me. Tell me how much I owe, Lord, I want to be paid again, like a lamb to the slaughter, like a sheep before his shearer, like a beggar to the grave, like a king, just a slave, born in poverty, died in cruelty, suffer agony, just for you and me. Tell me how much I owe, Lord, I want to repay. Oh Calvary, would you please just speak to me? Hallelujah, do you?
to God. Tell me how much I owe. Lord God Almighty. Hallelujah! Yes, Lord, Calvary. Oh, Calvary. Tell me how much I owe. I want to repay. I want to repay. I want to repay, God. Hallelujah. Oh God, if all that you required of me is to go tell the lost, then God, I will obey you. Tell the lost. Tell the lost. Tell the lost. Tell the lost that all God is asking of us. Go tell the lost. I owe,
but I want to repay. And a voice speaks to you from the hills of Judea. Tell the lost, tell the lost.
God bless you, Sister Pattinger. I love that song. Oh, Calvary. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Lord, I glorify you. Tell the lost. Tell the lost. God bless you. Believers living the Spirit-filled life. My brothers and sisters, we have seen and we have experienced that the wonderful plan of salvation is absolutely perfect. Glory to God. But we must admit that the vast majority of the Christians are living on the carnal plane. So the question arises, my brothers and sisters, is God's plan of salvation practical? Can we live it? Holy Ghost, help me. Is it possible for every believer to live their lives on the highest plane with God? Glory to God. My brothers and sisters, everything in God's word proves it is practical and possible for every Christian. Whoever has Christ's life in any measure may have it in all its fullness. Listen to what Jesus said in St. John 10:10. I am come that they might have life and have it more abundantly, God Almighty. Have life overflowing. And he's not talking much about material things. Glory to God. You can have overflowing life with God. Why? In Colossians 2, 9 and 10. For in him dwelleth all the fullness of the Godhead bodily. And in him we are made full, God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. In him we are complete. Lack nothing. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Who is the head of all principality and powers? Glory to God. John the Baptist, in two wonderful proclamations, declared the entire scope of Christ's work when he said, behold the Lamb of God that taketh away the sins of the world. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And the second he said, he that sent me to baptize in water, the same is he that baptized in the Holy Ghost. Glory to God. So what we are looking at here is Christ's twofold work. One was to take away sin. Glory to God. And to baptize in the Holy Ghost. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of Jesus Christ. So what the word of God is saying, my brothers and sisters, is that part of Christ's work was to bring every Christian into a definite relationship to the Holy Ghost. As he was to himself, although it was to a different type. Lord God Almighty. Glory to God. Glory to God. Every Christian can have a definite relationship with the Holy Ghost. Oh God. Jesus Christ uttered John's statement in two invitations which he gave to sinners to come unto him and drink of the water of life. Listen to what Christ said. But whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst. Hallelujah. But the water that I shall give him shall become in him, my God, a well. Woo! Yes, Lord, I feel my helper coming now. Shall become a well of water springing up into everlasting life. Glory to God. Glory to God. Then he said to John in John 7:37-38. Now, on the last day of the feast, the great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried, saying, If any man thirst, hallelujah, let him come unto me and drink. He that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, out of your innermost being, out of your belly, shall flow, rivers of living water. Somebody worship him. Somebody worship him. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Because you see, brothers and sisters, hallelujah, if Jesus is a river and the devil block up the one that you don't have nothing more, my God, but if he block up one, another one flowing. And if he block up another one flowing, another one keep flowing, another one keep flowing. Hallelujah. So it is possible to live the highest life in Christ, because he said, out of your innermost being shall flow rivers.
of living water. The Holy Ghost is Christ's gift to the believer. What the gift was, we are told. The Bible said, but this spake he of the Spirit, which they that believe on him were to receive. The Spirit was not yet given because Jesus was not yet glorified. Please note, in this verse, Jesus tells us three things. What the gift was, the Holy Ghost. Lord God Almighty, to whom given? They that believed on him. When bestowed? When Jesus was glorified. Church of God, his work as a sin bearer must be accomplished first. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So he had to go to the cross first. He had to die on that cross. Buried in the tomb. Resurrected from the dead. Ay, God Almighty. And ascended to his Father. Oh, glory. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ay. It is then, as the glorified Christ, that he would bestow his wonderful gifts. Because remember, 10 days after his ascension, the Holy Ghost came. 40 days after his resurrection and ascension, and 10 days after, 50th, Pentecost. Because when he went back, when he ascended to heaven, he went back to present himself to his Father as the glorified. That's why, remember, he said to Mary, don't touch me. Don't touch me yet. Don't touch me. I don't ascend to my Father yet. My Father don't approve of the work that I accomplish. It's not finished yet. Glory to God. Hallelujah. But Jesus said to the disciples that it is expedient that I go. But if I go, I will send you another comforter to live in you. Not just to be with you, but to live in you. Anywhere you are, he will be in you. God Almighty, if you're down in the valley, the Holy Ghost in you. If you're in the middle of the ocean, the Holy Ghost is. My God. If you're in the Red Sea, the Holy Ghost is there. If you're in the middle of Jordan, the Holy Ghost is there. If you are confronted by your Goliath, the Holy Ghost is there. If you're in affliction, God. Hallelujah. In the dark of the midnight, the Holy Ghost is there. Jesus could only be with his disciples one place at a time. Glory to God. But the Holy Ghost, Sister Sandra, can be everywhere and anywhere with you. For him living in you. So anywhere you go as a believer, you carry him. So that is why I'm not afraid by the terror by night. Nor the arrow that flyeth by day. Nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness. Not for the destruction that wasted at noonday. For through the power of the Holy Ghost, 1,000 shall fall at my side, and 10,000 at my right hand. But it shall not come nigh thee. Hi, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So Jesus told the disciples that he was to live in them as an abiding spiritual presence. Glory to God. That there would be a divine inflow of life supernatural in quality. Glory to God. A quality water flowing at you. Quality power. A flow in you. So when that flow in you, you must live quality life. Ay, God Almighty. God Almighty. Hallelujah. A divine inflow of life supernatural in quality. Quality. Supernatural. In quality, glory to God, it's no ordinary life. It's not an ordinary life when the Holy Ghost lives in you. Brothers and sisters, you are not just an ordinary person walking on earth. You have supernatural quality life dwelling in you, living in you, flowing through you. Oh, God Almighty. So the devil mustn't have the believer like a golf ball. And he take you. And him come back and him carry on us. And him drive you in that hole there. Lord God. Almighty. You have supernatural power within you. Glory to God. To look at the devil and say, devil, get behind me, Satan. The Lord God rebuke you. You have the power to do it. The authority to do it. For life supernatural in quality dwells in you. You have the power to put the devil in place. Oh God. It's not only life. Supernatural in quality. But there must be divine outflow of life supernatural in power. Glory to God. The outflow can't be less than the inflow. For what inflow within you is what must flow out of you. So the power of God and the glory and the holiness of God flow in you. Glory to God. And bad mind flowing out.
Let me preach now. Two of them can't flow.
Defining flowing quality and covetous life flow out of you. Divining flow in quality and curse word flow out of you. Lord God, brothers and sisters, the disciples were to live as Christ lived and to work as he worked. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So to provide power for that such a life, he promised that another comforter would come to take up his permanent abode in them. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. When Christ returned to glory, then he fulfilled his promise and sent back the Holy Ghost. On the day of Pentecost, the disciples in the upper room were baptized in the Holy Ghost. Glory to God. Glory to God. Brothers and sisters, hear me. Something moving me when I see people say they filled with the Holy Ghost and your mind bad. You're filled with the Holy Ghost and you can't forgive. You're filled with the Holy Ghost and you run from here to there to carry tears and make mischief. God Almighty, hear me, man. Lord God, help me, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen, Church of God. I want to show you something with the disciples. Are coming down here to show you when they're filled with the Holy Ghost, the change in their life. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. Hear me. From that day, from the day of Pentecost, everyone who has been organically and vitally united by faith with the living Lord receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Glory to God. The Bible said, hallelujah. And as I began to speak, the Holy Ghost fell on them as on us at the beginning. Glory to God. And in Acts 11, 15, 17, for as much then as God gave them the life gift, as he did unto us who believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, what was I that I could withstood God? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Single one of those who walk out of the upper room, walk out with the power of the Holy Ghost in their lives. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Let me say to you, my brothers and sisters, through the Son, through Jesus Christ, the Son, the sinner has life. Hallelujah. If I raise you from the dead, for you were dead in trespasses and sin, glory to God, and through his shed blood on Calvary, he raised you up and give you life. Hallelujah. But it's through the Holy Ghost, the believer has life more abundant. Aye, you must have more life than when you're saved. Abundant life than when you receive Christ. When you're filled with the Holy Ghost, something happened to you. Something supernatural enter you. Glory to God. I hear me, man. So what stumble you when you're just saved, when you're filled with the Holy Ghost, shouldn't stumble you. You have power to jump over it, to leap over it, to fly over it, to soar over it. Ah, so when you hear somebody who not filled with the Holy Ghost, someone lick or something about you. No, no, step where? Walk away from, you have more than that. Holy Ghost. My God. You have power. You have power. Power to walk away. Power not to answer them. Let me go, let me preach. Glory to God. Glory to God. You have power to walk away and come back at church tomorrow. Come sing. Blessed assurance. Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation. Purchase of God. A born of the Spirit. A washed in the blood. For this is my story. Something happening to me. Something living on me. This is my story. This is my song. I'm going to praise my God all the day long. Talk your talk. Chat your chat. Bad mind your bad mind. Gossip your gossip. Hey! But something down inside of me, telling me to go on. Telling me to go on. Go on. Go on. Go on. It's the Holy Ghost down inside of me telling me to go on. Go on. Hey. God Almighty. Hallelujah. Yes, sir. I feel the anointing. My God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. My brothers and sisters,
It is God's purpose that every believer should live a life of deep, growing spirituality.
You can't go to heaven as a taproot Christian. Your main root has to go down. It has to go down. It has to find its place in the life of Christ. Paul said you have to be rooted and grounded. Hallelujah. For hear me, as long as you are saved, Brother Alexander, storm will come. A whole heap of storm coming. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You can't be a banana tree Christian. You're going to blow over. Hallelujah. And nobody can catch you for long. Hallelujah. My God, for any day they move, they catch. You're going to go down. You're going to go down. You need your own root. You need root. Deep root. Solid root. Main root. Anchored in Jesus Christ. When your root go down, brother, you're not easily blown over. This time will come, but you're rock. You're rock. You're rock. You're rock. You're rock. But when the storm done, you're going to stand up again. You're going to stand up again for your root anchored. Your root anchored. Your root anchored. You must stand up. You must stand up. So let the storm rage high. They won't worry me. For I'm sheltered, safe within the arms of God. When your root gone down, brother, and the storm blowing, you can sing. I sing because I'm happy. I sing because I'm free. For his eyes is on the sparrow, and I know he watches me. Church of God, in Romans 7, the chapter going through right now, in Romans 7, you are looking at the picture of a carnal Christian. Romans 8, the life of a spiritual believer. Follow me. In 10 verses in Romans chapter 7, the letter I is used 25 times, and the Holy Spirit is not mentioned once. Lord God. In Romans chapter 8, The letter I is used only twice, where it is needed. And the Holy Ghost is mentioned 16 times. Thus, my brothers and sisters, we are compelled to believe that fullness of life in Christ means some advance in our relationship to the Holy Ghost. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And in one first command, God shows us the highest point the believer can reach in relationship to the Holy Ghost. In Ephesians 5:18, and be not drunk with wine, wherein excess, but be filled with the Holy Spirit. Be filled with the Holy Spirit. You have him dwelling in you, but that is not enough. As a believer, the Holy Ghost is in you. You must give the Holy Ghost right away. Let him fill you from center to circumference. So you can't get up and say, me, I go a sentence be tomorrow. And not ask the Holy Ghost if you can go. Give him right away. Give him the right away. You know, put up no red light that when he come, them have to stop. The green light must be on all the while in the Christian life. See the right away. They go. Go. Lead me. Lead me. Guide me along life's way. Lord, if you lead me, I cannot go astray. Let me walk each day with you. Lead me, O Lord. Lead me. My brothers and sisters, permit the Holy Ghost to energize you with his mighty power through filling you with himself. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Let me say to every young believer, no comfortable come sit down in a church and you're not filled with the Holy Ghost. Go after him. Hallelujah. Be filled with the Holy Ghost. This is every Christian birthright. Lord God Almighty. Every believer is your birthright. Because by virtue of the new birth, you have the right to such a fullness. Glory to God. Hallelujah. It is not the privilege of a few. It's not the privilege of a few. Whether you can read or can't read, the Holy Ghost is yours. My God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Whether you're small or big, the Holy Ghost is yours. Whether you live in a mansion or a hut, the Holy Ghost is yours. God Almighty. Hallelujah. But many of you are despising your birthright, as Esau did, and selling it out for a mess of pottage. Many of you are sacrificing your birthright for pleasure. For worldliness. Glory to God. I heard Sister Foster said something this morning. She said, God, 20 years from now, When we see her coming at the church, what the church going to look like? For we abandon the old time religion. We abandon the virtue of decency in the house of God. Some church not going to want me. Because you're not coming there, so. I told a young lady came here some time ago, and two of them and one of them come in and one piece of something up here. So me ask the other one, I said, she a part of the thing. She said, Mr. Teller said she can't come in there, so. Why she, which part them a pass old vehicle down a examiner? You can't go there, so. The standard of the church not going to be lowered for you to stay in there. Amen. This not change. So any minister change you where you're there, you go back there, go stay with him. But they not change a sentence, babe. It not change. Holiness still intact. Righteousness still intact. Sanctification still intact. Decency and good order. Aye, you're going to beg with me now. But hear me. I was preaching somewhere there and I said, I see some old mother. When they did young, then frat no shark, so. And I know when the old ya show legs. Come on, man. If you fill with the Holy Ghost and walk in the Spirit-filled life, brother, the Bible said you must be sober. You must be sober and teach the young woman how to dress properly. But if you're not dressed properly, you can't teach them how to dress.
Old man. When you, some of you see some old men too. Once long as so. Pants suck on to them like them are 16. Ministers too. Ministers. But you're not coming at the pulpit. You know, come in there. Yes, sir. I asked the question. I said, they must say, I'll then skin if you jump down in a hit.
So, when you see them walking, when you're filled with the Holy Ghost, Brother Sullivan, the aged man must be sober to teach the young man decency. A modest dressing. God, see the hand, they're like, you see when Green Lizard had a big sign, I'm back. Ministers. I know you're not like it. But may not preach where you like. Any day I have to get up and preach where the church want me to preach, it's time for pack up and say goodbye sentence be. When you walk in the Holy Ghost, brother, you must preach, thus saith God. You have a responsibility to present a holy church to God. And it don't make sense that I have a whole lot of young people here, compromise with them, then walk how they want to walk, dress how they want to dress, behave how they want to behave, because they have talent and you're going to hell with talent. God not going to charge me. Church of God, don't sell out your birthright. Do you come here today for what? Pleasure? Our money? Our position? No. Be filled with the Holy Ghost. This is every Christian need. Every Christian need him. No one can live a truly spiritual life without the spirit fullness. You cannot live a full blown Christian life without the fullness of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, when you look at Pentecost, 120 were filled at Pentecost. Only 11 of them were apostles. 11. Some were women who went back home to cook, to sow, to care for a family. Others were men who returned to the field and to the shop. Oh God. The names of only a few were recorded in the Bible. But I have no doubt that the rivers of living water flowed from their lives into other lives. Hear me. Do not think you are too old to be filled with the Spirit. It will save you. It will save you from the years of wilderness wandering of many older Christians. Some of us sit down in church from Wapikil Philip. I'm not filled with the Holy Ghost. Do not say that you are too old, that the hold of sinful habits is too strong upon you. Give the Spirit a chance. You know, it's last week I was in Santa Cruz. And I sat by myself on the back veranda looking at a guinea tree way behind the house with a rock. And I remember, I said, God, this is where I spend many days seeking for the Holy Ghost and the gift of God. Hallelujah. The only time some people seek for the Holy Ghost is when you say tarrying service. And some nobody come. You're not seek for the Holy Ghost when tarrying service. And at the time you come. No. Tarrying. Tarrying means waiting. So you don't have to wait on the night at church. You can wait every single day, anywhere you are. For you don't have to feel on your knees. Glory to God. You can feel at the workplace. You can feel over the washing machine. You can feel over the stove cooking. Lord God, hallelujah. Those women used to feel at the riverside, sitting over the wash tub. I scrub and I sing, God Almighty. And the power of God moved there. The power of God flowed through there. The power of God flowed through there. Hallelujah. My God, we want to go back to see some believer hungry again. Hungry for God. Hungry for God. Thirsty for God. Lord God Almighty. Aye. My brothers and sisters, I want you to notice something. That no Christian refused the blessing of such an experience. So none will be exempt from its responsibility. The fullness of the Holy Ghost is not optional. It's obligatory. It's not optional. Listen to what the Bible said of the apostles in the book of Acts. They were all filled with the Holy Ghost. Watch the word. Filled, full, fullness. Be filled with the Holy Ghost. A crisis did exist. Jesus was going. The church was going to be left in the hand. But none of the apostles, disciples filled with the Holy Ghost to carry the work. A crisis exists in the church. Let me tell you something. I see a lot of people enter ministry and then no sudden they're not filled with the Holy Ghost. They know. This is not something you can take on. And nobody got practice false tongues. For the devil knows their tongues not right. For powerless. When you speak in tongues, brother, somebody else must be touched. It's like a man shake a When you have dry gungo peas on a tree, if you touch one limb, everybody a shake. Yeah. The crisis exists. Jesus said, you can't go there, sir. You can't go to Samaria, sir. You can't go to Judea, sir. If you go there, so how you going to face Simon? How you going to face the sorcerer? Before I go to Santa Cruz, my clerk was telling me that there was a sister sick at her house. She called for prayer, but this other sister feels she more spiritual than them. So she run ahead of them. Lord God. And by the time she reached the door, she was flat on her back out there. Because the sister, it was a demon case. And the devil slapped her down right out there. Your little false tongue can't fight demons. Flesh can't fight demons. Paul, I know. Jesus, I know. But who are you? The devil will strip you naked. That's why Jesus said, go wait. Wait on your time. Wait on the anointing. Wait on the Holy Ghost. Wait on your calling. Not take it up. I remember, Rev, I think you hear Dr. Beeson preach it. When he was in Portland. And I remember that time when he talked about Kopi in a Portland. Lord God. Dr. Beeson said God told him to go to the house. But nobody couldn't go there. God told him to go to the house. And when he called three other ministers to go with him. And when he walked down to the house, and when they hear them a massive wind and the wind and door fly open, and you hear the roaring sound. The three of them run left him. These are men preaching. Say God called them. But Duppy run them. Where is the power? Did you receive the Holy Ghost? For no demon supposed to face and stand up before a Holy Ghost child of God. No demon supposed to invade your house. And you have the Holy Ghost. God Almighty, it's not optional. The crisis and a crisis is coming again in many of our churches. For the vast majority of our people coming into Church of God, not seeking the Holy Ghost. Let me talk. Not seeking for the power of the Holy Ghost. That is why when your finger hurt you, you have to call. The devil will go slap the phone out of your hand one at a time and you can't call. You must have the power within you to walk over your child and say, Satan, the Lord God rebuke you. Leave her. Leave him. Come out of here. Amen. You must walk over your child and lay your hand upon him and say, in the name of Jesus Christ, I command your fever to leave. Glory to God. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Yes, you may must lay your hand on your head and say, headache. Leave this body in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. You must be full of the Holy Ghost, man. The Bible said they were full of the Holy Ghost. Now they move from a crisis to a state. Something is now happening. Yes, some of them now are filled with the Holy Ghost. Aye. And they move from full of the Holy Ghost to filled unto all fullness. A process. Is filling up the Holy Ghost is a continuous process. It's not a one-time shot. Go in the book of Acts. The Bible said everywhere the apostles went, they were filled with the Holy Ghost. My God, sometimes the very place that they were refilled, the ground shook. The place shook because of the power, refilling of the power of God. Hallelujah. I was saying to my sister yesterday, I said, listen to me. Glory to God. Hallelujah. When you get in your closet with God, the secret place of the believer power is in your closet, not in church jumping. He's not in church jumping. Hallelujah. He's in your closet. Shut in with God in a secret place, man. Oh, Lord God Almighty. As you lay the sacrifice on the altar, God, here is the sacrifice. Only you can send the fire. I carry the sacrifice, God, but the fire must come from you. Here am I on the altar in my closet. God Almighty, send the fire. Send the fire. Let it consume. Set me on fire. That's what John Wesley said to God. God, in my closet, set me on fire. Set me on fire that when I get out of the closet, the world will see me burn. You must have a secret closet where some of you break away and hide away with your God. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. These apostles, they were filled more than once until we read of Stephen and of Paul that they were full of the Holy Ghost. But there was an inexhaustible, infinite fullness from which they might draw according to their receptive capacity. So there was a continuous infilling. This was a process. A process. The process must go on in your life until you're dead or raptured. The process of the infilling of the Holy Ghost or the refilling of the Holy Ghost must continue. The last time rain fall, how many tank did full of water? The dam full of water. You don't see that dry out? You need another shower. Or more than a shower too. Oh God. The crisis of life, the challenges of life, dry out some of us long time. Lord God, many of us, we come to church and we shout and a shake like Samson. But not either. But when last we go into the closet? When last we shut in with God? Samson shake. But the rope still tie him. Before Delilah trim him. In just do so on the rope, God. Before the world dry you out. My God, one song and you're a blessing. No. Some of us harp hang up. And I preached that this week. The harp hang up. The timbrel put on. We sit on a riverside. Let me say, somebody said something to me. There, Sister Sandra. And I said, listen to me. How you come to church to worship God? And you see when the sister turned this up and go this up. How you come to church and worship God and everybody move in there, you see? Where you are though? When I come to church, don't ask me who they are church. But who know their church and where they wear from, where they know wear. Now tell me someone, that sister over there, so we have on the black hat, a whole heap in there. Me no see one way at all. I don't come to church figure watch anybody. I come to church to worship. I come to worship. I don't come to church to listen who I chat. I come to worship. Glory to God. So when your drum, you see everything when your drum empty. But when your drum full, you focus. Church of God. spiritual. You must be filled and kept filled. Sometimes I'm coming home. Sometimes there is a great confusion here because one expects a spectacular manifestation of so wonderful an experience. Scripture clearly teaches us threefold manifestation of the Holy Ghost in the believer's life. A threefold. And I want to leave them threefold there with you. For many of us think it's just we get up speaking tongues and I push out the people. And for peeping at people's life. And say, Holy Ghost tell you when you know, say not tell you nothing. One of the manifestations of the Holy Ghost in the life of the believer is the realization of Christ's abiding presence. You must know and have the experience that Christ abide within you. Listen to Ephesians 3:16-17. That he would grant you according to the riches of his glory, that he may be strengthened with power through his spirit in the inward man, that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith. What Paul is saying to them, the Holy Ghost was real to the disciples. The Holy Ghost was real to the early church. It is the spiritual presence of the living Lord. Such an intense reality. Glory to God. This is one of the rich rewards of living the spirit-filled life. Glory to God. It's the reality of the presence of Christ with you. Hallelujah. The second thing is the reproduction of Christ's holy life in you. It's not just to speak in tongues, but when you're filled with the Holy Ghost, you must reproduce Christ's life. Hey, Lord God. Hallelujah. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, meekness, self-control. Against such there is no law. Watch this, brothers and sisters. Compressed into these nine graces is a marvelous picture of the character of Jesus Christ in its essential beauty and perfection. Such character is not the product of human nature, but the fruit of the divine nature. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So if Christ lives in you through the Holy Ghost, brother, my God, your life must reflect love. 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 And not only when the person compromises with you and agree with you in everything, but when he look upon you and tell you, say, a wrong for your brother wife or your sister husband, you must still love him. I love her, for is the reproduction of Christ's life in you. so you can't hear because the man tell you the truth. Glory to God. You must look like Christ. You must walk like Christ. You must behave like Christ. Glory to God. Some people will fling down them bag of church gate there so and go on bad. And yet next week then come, oh shaka 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 shaka. Come on, believers. You have Christ in you. And you will stand up in a sentence, be and curse and go on bad. And talk, say, you're not here. That's why you stay. Then you're not saved. But if you stay, you can't stay, so. If you have the Holy Ghost, you can't stay, so. The Holy Ghost is to reproduce the life of Christ in you. Christ can't hurt nobody. Christ can't tell nobody if he hurt them and burn them. He tell you the truth and he cut, but he heal. The reproduction of Christ's life. So when the world look at Brother Sullivan coming out there, he must see Christ. That's why the disciples were called Christians at Antioch. Because they said, no man, they may look like Christ. These men look like Christ. Why you think Judas tell them, say, the one where you see me kiss? Because they couldn't identify Christ away from the apostles. Because they look alike. The final thing. The reenactment of Christ's supernatural power. But he shall receive the Holy Ghost power. After the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and he shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the earth. God Almighty, as he sent his disciples for to do a supernatural task, he promised to endue them with a supernatural power. All power belongs unto Christ. But he delegated his power to us through the Holy Ghost. Amen. Glory to God. That's why he said, when you're filled with the Holy Ghost, brother, one of you, we stay at St. Mary, Brother Watson, run 1,000. But if 10 of us, you there at St. Mary, me there at St. Anne, one there at Kingston, one at Westmoreland, one only saw 10,000, we are drive out. 10,000. We're driving out. The reenactment of his supernatural power. Wherever God is, or Christ is, in his fullness, he manifests himself in power. Hey, Sometimes you walk into some service and you hear some people say, boy, people are run up and down and a drum press and a shout this and do us and you say, boy. And all you hear keyboard a play and drum set and knock and your drum high touch. Lord God, God in you. And yet the man gone home. No save. Gone home with him problem. Gone home, Lord God. Then how God in the house and him come out in the same condition. Anywhere the power of God is moving, brother, something must happen. God can't come in and you're still in a chain. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I know how many of you remember one baptism we have here. Our God, when the last candidate stepped out and I was about to close and give the other one, a young lady was sitting right over the back where my sister was sitting there. She was supposed to be baptized and she changed her mind. And she don't run about there. And as the power of God hit her right as she can't drop. And my foot and the next thing me know, I know the water she there. That's the power of God. You can say to anybody, the Holy Ghost is in the house. For something happened. Glory to God. Let me close. I was many years ago. Two things happened. It was in Marchtown. I went to do a crusade. I pastored the church for 6 months until it was assigned to somebody because I was a district overseer. Make all the trouble in there. But when we're leaving, one of the deacons said to me, say, that the pastor that took over the church invited me to come back and do a week of crusade. The deacon, one of the deacons met me and said, the other man said, you can't come back down. Lord God. That made me more determined to go. I don't know where I'm getting power from. But me know where it may come from. And listen to me, Rev. The very day I was going into Marchtown, he come to the bus stop, and when he see me left, he will left and go back. You know, but I can't wait for the bus. And I see God mash up some things in Marchtown that week. One lady inside there. I was preaching on the power of God. And when I finished, I raised the song, what more do you want him to do? And I see this big, fat woman. Nobody in a no size store. God Almighty. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And I saw God take up the woman from the back of the church like down there. Spin her like a gig. I'm here, boof at the altar. Aye. The deacon said to me, said, boy, they think she dead. Me said, no, God not kill her. I save her. He not kill her. Not even a bruise. For you see, she hear she drop boof, but the Holy Ghost and she drop in her. God Almighty cushion her. Down there, catch her and put her down there. Aye. deacon said to me when I go home, I was staying at the deacon house. He said, Rev, you don't know what happened tonight, you know. You don't know what the Holy Ghost do tonight. That the woman there are the baddest woman in there. Not a man in there beat, fight her and beat her. She beat off every man. In a match town. Lord God, when he lick for him, man, he put him down there, she sit down for him, and he can't get up. Holy Ghost. Oh, Lord God. But she couldn't sit down for one man. One man lick her with the anointing power of the Holy Ghost. And she was knocked out on the floor. Hey, she couldn't sit down upon Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost, sit down upon her. Give me a chance, no man. Holy Ghost, sit down on her at the altar. Transform her life. And the next night when you see she come, she was like a lamb to the slaughter. When she come the following night at church. Oh, glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of Jesus Christ. And finally, my brothers and sisters, when I was transferred to Trelawney, Pastor Trevor Grant and myself, we were coming from